ओके ओके वी आर डन विद जुडिशरी। Okay, so if we are done with our judiciary, today we will study Indian geography. Today we will study Indian geography. All right? Is it clear, boys? Yay! So wait a minute, for I have stopped sharing. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. I hope it is visible to everyone. I hope screen is visible to everyone. Yes. So in geography, till I remember, we have finished drainage, natural lakes. Yes, we have to study this. Yes. So today we will study, okay, or we will continue. Achha, boys, with the judiciary, we have finished our polity, all right? Okay, with judiciary, we have finished our polity. That was the last topic of Indian polity, Indian judiciary. All right, yes. And some more few here and there, some important things are left, which I will share you, all right. For example, the important amendments, okay, important articles, some just few documents which are left, which I will share on the website, okay. All right, boys. On the website, and you can download it from there. Yes, yes. Okay. Okay. So everyone ready? Is everyone ready? Nirmal Mayur, Manish Kelvin John, Anshu. Everyone ready? Write in the chat. All right, so let's start, or let's resume our Indian geography, and we will try to finish Indian geography. Okay, boys, after Indian geography, we will take up Indian history. All right, the most boring part of GAT, we will take up Indian history, and then so on we will go. Okay, so today we are going to start types of soils in India. What are the various types of soils we have, their characteristics, and their classification, how the soils or the types of soils are classified. So soil, first, what is soil? Soil, India is an agrarian country, all right, and soil is its prime resource. As you know, India is mostly dependent on agriculture, and for agriculture, soil is very much important. Soil is very much important, or it is a prime resource for India. It plays a vital role in the economy of India. Yes, soil is absolutely important for our economy, for our industries also. Yes, absolutely right. And in industries, to be precise, agro-based industries. Agro-based industries means agriculture-based industries. Agro-based industry means agriculture-based industries. About 65 to 70% of our country's population is still dependent on agriculture. Still dependent on agriculture. That's why our India is an agrarian country. Okay. The Indian Council of Agriculture Research, ICAR, okay, what they did, they set up an All India Soil Committee in the year of 1953. So this council, Indian Council of Agriculture Research, what they did, okay, we need to improve our agriculture, okay, we have so much potential in our agriculture field. So to explore over the various resources, the various soil types and agriculture, they set up a All India Soil Committee in the year of 1953. Okay. And this committee, what they did, they distributed the soil in 8 types. They distributed the soil in a total of 8 types. In a total of 8 types. Which are alluvial soil, rigor or black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil, mountain soil, saline and alkaline soil, pitty and marshy soil. These are the 8 classifications, okay, which our soil committee in the year of 1953 gave us. So now what are these? So now what are these types of soils, or what are the 8 classifications? What are their characteristics? Okay, we'll study them in detail. We will now study them in detail. So this is the, if you look at the map of the India, this is how the soils are classified. All right. When you will take the part of Jammu and Kashmir, Uttarakhand, okay, parts of Himachal, parts of Punjab, they all make up to forest and mountain soil, and some parts of Sikkim, and then we have some parts of Arunachal Pradesh, they all have forest and mountain soil. And when you will take up this blue part, this light blue part, it is all made up of alluvial soil. Red part is made up of red and yellow soil. Black soil is at the center, or you can say at the place of Deccan Plateau and Central Highlands. All right. Then here we have some laterite soil and arid soil. Okay, this is how the classification goes. I hope you got a brief idea of how the soils are divided in our country, where they are present, or at least just an idea. Okay, in detail we'll study them in detail. Okay, exactly in which all states, what are their properties, what are the types of crops that can be grown on them. Is it clear to everyone? Okay, so if it is clear, let's move on to, or let's study in detail, okay, about one by one about the various classifications. All right, let's study in detail. So first we will study about alluvial soil. Okay, first let us understand what is the term alluvial means. Okay, what does the term alluvial means? So alluvial basically means the deposition of material by sea and river is called alluvial. The deposition of materials by sea and river, when sea and rivers are flowing, sorry, due to the action of water of sea and river, okay, they bring up small particles and which get deposited. These small particles we call them as alluvium, and the soil which is formed due to the deposition of this alluvium, the soil which is formed due to deposition of this alluvium is called alluvial soil. When you will take up this type of soil, okay, it is mainly found in Indo-Gangetic and Brahmaputra plain. It is mainly found in Indo-Ganga and Brahmaputra plain. That is whole of northern India, you can say, and some part of river basins in the south and some in the plateau region, as you have seen in the map. Just 1 minute, boys. This soil is also found in the deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Kaveri, and Krishna. All right, this is also found in the deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Kaveri, and Krishna. When you will take up the classification, it is classified into two types: new alluvial soil, that we call it as Khadar, and the older alluvium we call it as Bhangar, which we have already studied, if you guys remember. Yes boys, yes. When you will take up the older alluvium, it is slightly found in the elevated areas. Okay, elevated area means slightly hilly areas. Okay, slightly hilly areas far away from the river. This type of older alluvium, this particularly older alluvium, is basically clay and sticky in nature. When you will take the case of newer alluvium, it is found in the floodplains. All right, and this is very much fertile when compared to the older alluvium. Newer alluvial is very much fertile is compared to the older alluvium. When you take the case of what are the types of crops which can be grown, okay, the alluvium soil as a whole is very suitable for rabi and kharif crops, okay, like cereals, cotton, oil seeds, and sugarcane. Both rabi and kharif types of crops can be grown on this alluvium soil. This soil covers about 46% of the total area of the total 46% of the total area of our country. All right, alluvium soil. Is it clear, boys? Is Is it clear, boys? Good. So if it is clear, let's go to the next type of soil. The next type of soil which we are going to study is rigor or black soil. Okay, this is basically developed extensively upon the lava plateaus of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh. Okay, and mainly Malwa Plateau, parts of Malwa Plateau, and it is formed due to the volcanic activities. When the volcanic activities are happening, when the volcanoes are erupting, due to which, because of their action, we get black soil or rigor soil. This soil is very much fertile. It contains high percentage of lime, iron, and a moderate amount of potash. These are the important minerals which are found in black or rigor soil: lime, iron, or potash. This type of soil is suitable for the cultivation of cotton. It is very much suitable for the cultivation of cotton. Okay, is very much suitable for the cultivation of cotton. That's why it is often also called as black cotton soil. Black cotton soil. Some important crops which are grown on it are, first is cotton, as you guys know, jowar, wheat, linseed, gram, fruits and vegetables. These are the main crops which are grown on rigor or black soil. Okay, and black soil is highly retentive of moisture. Retentive means high water holding capacity. High water holding capacity. Is it clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? Ninwal Mayu, Ramanbir, Anshu. Is it clear to everyone? Everyone, guys, respond. Everyone, respond in the chat. Everyone, respond in the chat. Okay, so if it is clear, let's go to the next type of soil, that is red soil. Okay, that is red soil. Red soil basically develops on granite and gneiss rocks. Okay, these are the names or a particular type of rocks. Okay, under low rainfall conditions. Under low rainfall conditions. That is, rainfall means weathering will take place. Okay, due to the weathering of the metamorphic rocks. Due to the weathering of the metamorphic rocks. This soil is red in color because it contains high concentration of iron oxide. Because of the high concentration of the iron oxide, this soil is red in color. That's why it is called red soil. These soils are friable and medium fertile. Okay, found mainly in whole of Tamil Nadu, southeastern Karnataka, northeastern and southeastern Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, major parts of Orissa, and the hills and plateaus of northeast India. This is the location, or this is the areas where this particular red soil is found. These soils are deficient in phosphoric acid, organic matter and nitrogenous material. They are deficient in phosphoric, organic matter and nitrogenous materials. The crops which can be grown on this type of, on the red soil is wheat, rice, millets and pulses. Wheat, rice, millets and pulses. These are the types of crops which can be grown on them. Is it clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone? Clear, boys? Yes. So if it is clear, let's go to the fourth type of soil. Let's go to the fourth type of soil. Till now, we have studied alluvial soil, black soil, red soil. Okay. Till now, we have studied alluvial soil, black soil, and red soil. Let's study laterite soil. Laterite is a kind of clay rock or soil formed under high temperature and high rainfall and with the action of alternate dry and wet seasons. Okay, this is the condition or this is the process or these are the requirements or conditions which are required for preparation or for the making of this laterite soil. Laterite and lateritic soils are found in Maharashtra, Western Ghats in Kerala, Karnataka, places in Odisha, small parts of Chota Nagpur Plateau, and in some parts of Assam, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and in Western West Bengal, particularly in Birbhum district. This is the location of the laterite soil. The crops which can be grown in this particular soil are coffee, cashew. Okay, these are the two important crops which can be grown on laterite soil. And this soil is unsuitable for agriculture. This soil is unsuitable of agriculture. Why unsuitable? Because it contains high content of acidity and inability to retain moisture. Okay, inability to retain moisture. Low water holding capacity, and this soil is very much acidic. That's why it is not suitable for the agriculture. Then how? Not suitable doesn't mean nothing will grow. It doesn't mean nothing will grow. It is not, barren. Okay. Particularly these two type of crops can only be grown. Only these two types. Okay. You can't grow any other crop. That's why it is suitable, unsuitable for agriculture. And these are plantation crops. Okay, plantation crops. Only two types. Whereas on a normal soil, you can grow so many types of crops. Clear, boys? Is it clear to everyone? Okay, so let's move on to the fifth type, that is desert soil. The fifth type is desert soil. It is mainly found in the parts of Rajasthan, Haryana, southern Punjab. Okay. Yes, it is found in Rajasthan, Haryana, and southern Punjab. In absence of sufficient rainwater, soils have become saline and rather unfit for cultivation. Because of very low rainwater, because they get hardly any water, the soil has become very much saline. Hence, it is unfit for cultivation. But still, cultivation can be done. Okay. In spite of that, cultivation can be carried on with the help of modern irrigation. With the help of modern irrigation practices, we can cultivate some crops here. Okay. Such as wheat, bajra, groundnut can be grown on this particular desert soil. This type of soil is particularly rich in phosphates, calcium, nitrogen, and humus. Phosphates, calcium, nitrogen, and humus. Clear to everyone? Clear to everyone? Acha, tell me, what are the types of soils we have studied till now? Give me the names. The types of soils which we have studied till now. Give me the names. All of them. All five types. All five types. ALBRL. Alluvial, black, red, laterite, desert. ABRLD. Alright. ABRLD. Yes, alluvial, black, red, laterite, and desert soil. These five types we have studied till now. Let's move on to the sixth type of soil, that is mountain soil. So, alluvial, alluvial, black, red, laterite, desert. Now comes the mountain soil. Okay, mountain, as the name suggests, this type of soil, okay, it is found in higher altitude, okay, on the mountains. That's why it is called mountain soil. The characteristics of this particular soil are not